Has this happened to you? Have you ever seen gameplay footage of a game that you liked many, many years ago, then you painfully regret the fact that you sold your consoles for fast food money? There. Look at it go. Well, today in our first part of our emulation series, we'll look at how we can emulate those games that we fondly remember so many years ago. Disappointment.
Now, in order to go over emulation, we have to understand what exactly it is. Hell, you can probably ask any gamer nowadays and they would understand, since that is practically one of the only ways to play some older games out there. Emulation allows a computer or device to emulate a video game, console's hardware, and play its games on the emulating platform. Most commonly now, it's used on a lot of newer consoles like the PlayStation Network and all the PS1 games you can possibly play, as well as Nintendo's Virtual Console as well. Nowadays, the biggest selling point of newer consoles are the fact that they can support classic games. Since the mid-90s, many programmers have been reverse engineering hardware in order to play many of our favorite games on a simple computer. Some emulators have been a failure, which if you want to check the link right there, it's a hilarious stream of one of the first Super Nintendo emulators being used. As more time passed, emulation has grown to a larger degree. Without it, some of the best games ever made wouldn't have been officially released over here. For example, one game, Final Fantasy V, wasn't officially released over the States until 1999 on a compilation PlayStation disc. It wasn't until the rise of emulation that some dude decided that, since we weren't gonna be able to get the game, might as well hack it and fan translate it so the rest of us can finally play it. I can go on about the other projects such as this, but I digress. Let's get to work on emulating some games. Now to start, we're gonna do something extremely basic. How about we start with one of my favorite games on the NES, Blaster Master. First, we need to grab an emulator, which is the program we need to play our games. I use this website here. On the left, click on Nintendo NES. Scroll down, and you can see a lot of emulators available for the system you desire. For now, let's select the top-rated one, Nestopia. Click on the link, then click on it again. And you should be able to download a zip file. Unlike most programs, emulators usually come in zip files. So save it onto your desktop for now, so it's easier to find later. Next, open the zip file and extract the files into a new folder, which we'll call NESEMU, or something similar. Then extract the files into that folder. This should take a second. Open the folder you just created, and open the nestopia.exe, and our emulator should pop up. It may look intimidating at first, but once you get started emulating and adjusting some settings, it should be a breeze. But of course, since we are new to this, I'll go over some main things to note. To put things simply, if the game was on a cartridge, we would need to find its ROM file. To find the ROM file, we need to go to Google and search for the game ROM we want, and the ROM file should pop up. Now here's the thing, I'm not going to provide you with any exact websites for this. For one, the games that you're downloading are considered copyright work, even though they're almost 30 years old. So it's still considered illegal. Usually ROM files come as either a zip or, since we're playing an NES game, a .nes file. Once you find the ROM, which I have right here, you'll basically be ready to play it by dragging it into our emulator. See, simple. Lastly, here's some more things to know if you want to optimize your gameplay experience. First thing, Nestopia defaults your gameplay into the use of the keyboard, but most people are more comfortable using a controller of some kind. I have a wireless Xbox 360 controller with an adapter, but any USB controller that is compatible with your computer will work. First, close your emulator. Then hook your controller up. Restart the emulator. Then go to Options and Input. Go to Set All, and set your controller inputs according to the mapping list as it goes down. Left to left, right to right, you get the idea. Hit OK, play your game, and it should be able to work. Remember, if you want to play with a controller, make sure you plug it in before starting the emulator, otherwise it won't be recognized. I know this seems like a common sense thing, but believe me, I can't tell you the amount of times I've seen people throw a fit over this because it wasn't working. There are plenty of other options to explore here too, such as video modes, that allow you to change the screen filters to make it seem like an old school TV, full screen modes, and aspect ratio sizes as well, to get the most experience out of your NES emulation experience. Man, I sound like an E3 spokesperson. God, how I degenerated. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. I plan on doing more emulation videos in the future and other neat gaming videos. Check out my previous videos as well on my Smart Mirror and Quick Tips as well. And you guys love my Smart Mirror, don't you?